Can we just like, come on, man.
You know, when you start it, you can't stop.
Come on, man.
That is true, though. We do live
like
in an
the
era.
Match. You can't pause.
We're starting the pod, bro. Turn it
yeah,
off.
Yeah, I'm on.
I'm not. No. Can we just
give him
come
the
on,
phone?
Man.
Where's the basket?
Give me the phone.
Okay. I'm AFK, bro.
Are you kidding me right now?
No, I'm good.
Can you just like, I don't feel safe with it on your lap.
It's an addiction.
It's like a gun. I don't feel safe with
that
on your lap.
Literally,
put it on
it's
safety.
Almost over.
I'm sorry, bro. What game is this?
It's League. It's literally like, I can't pause. I can't leave. I get penalized.
It's okay, bro.
Yeah, no, it's fine.
All right. Let's talk about it.
I was gonna put it over here.
Yo, just leave
I'm just confiscating it. Yo,
I love it.
All right, we're here. Welcome to another episode of Fun with Dumb. God. I am here with my best friends, Rick Lee Rex Dizzy.
What's up? Yeah.
Yeah. League of Legends. That's who we are.
It went to the mobile device, man.
What's up, fellas? It's been a while, especially for Rek to have returned to the show.
I've been here in months, I realize.
Has it been that long?
Yeah.
How you feel, man?
My first time in 2024, I believe, right?
That's what's up, bro.
How do I feel?
Yeah.
How do I look like I feel?
You look like you're thrilled to be here.
I'm super thrilled. Be with my friend Rick.
Come on, baby. How much are you thinking about the game right now?
You were like, this is ridiculous because I'm trying to start the pod. Yeah. He was going to just play through the pod.
No, it's like, there's like 2 minutes left.
What's happening in the game right now? Walk us through this.
Okay.
I've never played League of Legends.
Just like when you play some, okay, first of all, we don't have to say the game.
Okay.
Because I'm a beginner and I look like a but yeah, like when you play these games that are like live, like, you're literally, like, you can't pause the game. You're in it.
You could technically pause the game, though. Like, you can press pause.
Yeah, but then you're letting your whole team down.
You're letting your whole squad down.
Oh, wait. So
I'm not
going to
lie to you.
Online.
Yeah, yes, you're an integral part of the team.
Yes.
So there's people right now wondering
so
why.
So mad, yeah.
My girl and I, we get into these fights all the time. When I used to play Call of Duty, you know, it's Warzone, so I'm playing with JL. We're relying on each other. That's my partner in war, right? We're going through it. We're in the trenches right now, front
line.
And Donna's like, come here real quick. My back itches, you know? Me leaving that computer for 2.5 minutes, 45 seconds.
He's letting his
I'm
bro
letting
die.
The squad
yeah,
down.
But you're letting your girl down because she has an itchy back.
What's more important?
You know,
it's more important.
When duty calls, bro, I'm letting
it's a
you
back.
Know.
You know, we're talking about lives here.
I'll tell you exactly what
JL's lives matter.
I'll tell you what those dudes on the other end are doing. They're like, he's probably busy. Okay.
No,
they don't
not.
Care.
They're
they do
screaming.
Not care.
Spit flex are just spraying on the screen, everything.
Oh my God.
Punching
oh
walls.
They really don't care. I promise you. Anyways, good seeing you, Rek. Welcome back to the show, man. We missed you.
Glad to be here.
Yeah, man.
See some new changes. Got a new guy. Who's that?
Alex?
Yeah, the Wayne's World
Alex,
guy.
Alex, what's up, man?
Not much.
The Wayne's World
good
guy.
Day.
Quickly, he's not on the pulse there. He took a couple of seconds. Yeah.
Like, come on, Alex.
We're having a deja vu, you replaced him already?
Nah, he's over here. He's in the cut. But we've decided to throw a camera on Alex. Not necessarily because he's pleasant to look at, but just because he has things to say.
You think they bring add value?
What's up, Alex? Do you play video games?
Actually, yes.
We knew this.
Okay, yeah, I've been playing mostly MLB The Show 24. I've been playing a little bit of Helldivers 2.
Cut his mic.
But I've been playing, you know, video games since I was a kid.
So you know about the multiplayer dilemma, right?
Of course.
It's not like a linear game back in the day where you just try to go from one level to the other. It's an immersive war situation. Seconds matter. Do you understand what I'm saying, Alex?
I understand, but we will always have someone in our life that wants something done right now, and that's never going to change.
If you ever get deeper than normal, if you ever...
Hey, sounds like relationship problems.
Yeah,
god damn. Okay, bro.
Has video games ever been a problem in your relationship, Alex?
Not really. I tend to game like when my girl's asleep or times when it's not like really affecting
you're a sneaky little gamer.
Yeah, but for the most part, you know, just like anything, video games can become an addiction as well, especially with the way games are designed these days.
Oh my God. Can we just switch? All right, that's it.
Is this AI? This is literally AI. Alex the intern, AI. Yeah. It's straight up.
It's like a Quora answer.
That name really works. It's a Quora answer.
Yeah.
He's not from Korea. He's from Quora.
I love you, Alex.
We love you, man. I just got back from Coachella.
Yo.
Congrats, dude.
Thanks.
How many days?
I did 2 out of 3.
Are you crazy?
Well, I mean, I just feel like...
Two is good.
Two is good.
Three is kind of crazy.
Yeah, I considered staying the third day.
Yeah. What made you not...
I don't know. Like, all the acts I really wanted to see was towards the end. So I would have to stay all the way towards the end of the thing. If I could just stay the first half and then leave like...
So you missed all the acts that you wanted to see because you didn't want to stay to the end, right?
No. I wanted to... All my acts that I wanted to see played the first two nights.
Mm.
Obviously, No Doubt.
No Doubt.
Killed it.
No Doubt.
You know how many No Doubt jokes there has been like this past weekend when I say No Doubt? They're like, No Doubt. So I had to laugh like 50 times. Anyways, I loved the No Doubt's performance. I think Gwen Stefani might be the top female performer alive.
Make a compilation of
why
top.
Not, why not just the top performer?
Okay.
She's a woman?
She's one of the top performers alive. No, she's one of the top performers alive.
Yeah.
But definitely out of the women, I think she is the top performer.
Wow. What about among the men?
She's top 20. Top. I don't know.
Get him.
Now you're messing me up. I'm like thinking twice.
We didn't even need Steffi here.
I'm thinking twice.
You having doubts.
That's crazy. She's the, I mean, yeah. When
her
I saw
voice,
the lineup,
man.
Yeah, when I saw the lineup, I was like, if there's one act I want to see, it's probably No Doubt.
Because we've all seen that iconic video clip of her in the 90s at the Anaheim concert where she's performing Just a Girl.
Mm.
I've watched that since I was a teenager, before YouTube even existed. I don't even know how I got my hands on the clip.
Right.
No, actually, probably was when you. It was
back when
teenager.
You were just a girl.
So she kills that clip. I've been watching her do the same like crowd work stuff in that clip for years. You know what I mean? The breakdown where she tells the crowd like, all the girls, stay quiet. I need just the boys to sing along, just the girl.
Yeah, yeah.
And she ran that back at Coachella. It was sick.
You sent me that clip.
I did, right?
Like multiple times. Like, have you ever seen this? I was like, yeah. Every time.
But it's dope. It's a dope clip.
Yeah.
And she ran that at Coachella, and I just got chills, man.
So the demographic of Coachella is more, it's a younger crowd, right? No Doubt was, no, would it's it be? Like,
it's no, mixed. It's super mixed.
It's super mixed.
Yeah. Okay, you never been?
I've been, I don't think I've been to Coachella.
Mm. No.
Not really a festival guy, to be honest with you, man.
Let's get you out there, man.
You know, I'm not really a festival.
You're not festive, huh?
I'm festive, but I'm just, you know, whole
I can see him having a lot of fun at
I've
festivals.
Seen you at least 25 Korean festivals. At least 25 Korean festival with traditional drumming and taekwondo demonstrations. You have been there.
I'm a fest guy.
You are a fest.
Yeah.
You don't go to festivals.
No.
But you will go to a K-Fest.
Come on. I'm a fest guy, dude. I'm one of the best fests. Trust me.
We'll get you... tickets to Coachella next year.
Yeah.
But let me know. Okay, explain why you don't like festivals.
Okay, first of all, what's the accommodations looking like? Because when I'm thinking festival, I've been to like my share of like I did Rock the Bells, you know? I went to a rave type situation.
Oh, this is a bigger, grander scale.
Bro. It's like
there's dust.
It feels like suffering. I understand. Like when I go camping, it's part of camping to get dirty, get bug bites.
It feels
natural.
Yeah.
It feels natural. But when you go to a music festival, I'm trying to listen, you know, in comfort. Maybe it's an age thing. I don't know. I'm not really a
festival. You can't do the gen pop anymore.
I can't do the gen pop anymore, bro. I need air condition. The mist tents don't do anything. I need I don't want to pump for water ever.
Wow,
you know
Mr. Underground Hip Hop wants luxury, huh? Mr. Underground, Year of the Ox lyricism wants luxury.
I'm just saying, dude.
You know, I went to Coachella last year.
Yeah.
And
you did.
Bathrooms weren't that bad.
The facilities were okay.
I took a dump.
You took a dump.
Yeah.
You had a great time.
I had a good time.
Yeah, I saw you jamming out with your friends, dancing. Out. I think you were wearing beads, if I'm not mistaken.
Beads?
Anal beads? No, just beads in general. But you, who'd you go watch last year? I was there.
No, Rosalia. She was amazing.
Yeah, she was.
That was my favorite performance for sure.
Yeah. Here's the thing. One thing I really respect is I saw so many performers. I walked around, just even peeked in each tent for a bit, right?
Yeah.
Everybody's visuals are so on point. Every single artist.
I gotta say, Doja Cat's performance yesterday was like, it was like watching a live music video.
I thought, I feel you, the mud stuff,
yeah,
the Yeti with the blonde hair stuff, yeah, that was whole so sick.
Was crazy.
I really thought, like, just, like, those images, the fact that they just stick to your mind immediately after, like, those are just iconic scenes, you know?
Yeah.
So I love performances where it becomes theater like that. Stage design, you know? Before, it's just, you know, running around on stage with a DJ, that's cool, that's hip-hop. But now with like the Travis Scott's, I see the Kanye, even the Tyler, the Creator stuff's crazy.
What would you do if you had unlimited budget?
I would just have it all as a screen, you know, like the ceiling, walls.
Just a screen, bro.
Wait, hold on. You got to put something on the screen. So what would you put on the screen? You know, Alex, could you turn on the AC real quick?
I would assume that you'd want some like angels just floating, you know what I'm saying? A huge cross.
Yeah. I might just do like
that. And then you get nailed on it.
Yeah, the first.
Oh my God. He comes out with a cross on his back.
You know, it would be tight because you, Zoe, and JL on the cross.
Shut the f-
all oh, on the cross made out of a fork and a knife.
All three of y'all on the cross. That would go so hard, bro.
Would be so hard where, dude? We'd be canceled in a second.
Second half of the show.
Yeah.
You're resurrected. You come out of the cave.
After intermission.
Insane, bro. I mean, there's so much stuff you could do. Like, you know, you're the ox. You can do the when you play Stampede.
Right.
You can have crazy Stampede action.
Exactly. That's what I mean by screen. I don't know about building out a whole thing. You know what I mean?
But how about you, Rek? What would you do? Unlimited Coachella budget for your live performance. What would you do?
Obviously, you have a giant frog on stage.
How big?
You remember Up in Smoke tour?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
When who had it? They had a huge head on that.
Yeah, I think it was Game, actually. I think it was the Game.
I don't think it was the Game.
Anyway.
It's either Eminem or Dre or anyway, yeah, like a huge frog. Yeah.
And then you're gonna like be on it or
yeah, why not? I'll get them to float me in the air.
That's it.
And I hop from each thing.
Yeah.
Each lily pad.
That's tight.
What about you? It's just a huge classroom.
Why do I have a huge classroom?
I'm dumb.
I kind of want some like live animals.
Oh my God.
I feel like people haven't done the live animals at a show. I mean,
bro, live animals is too many factors for failure, man.
And nowadays, like people will be like, animal cruelty.
Yeah, that's true.
That's true.
You know what we did see? I was at one of the shows and there was like this husky dog that has like 3 million followers.
What?
Do you know this husky dog that's an influencer? This dude had a husky dog that's like has 3 million followers. Dan's like taking pictures with him.
That's ridiculous.
Okay, Alex, never mind. Okay. I was waiting for Alex to pull this up.
Very nice.
Is it Maya?
I don't know. Maya, it doesn't even matter anymore because you're late on the draw.
Husky could be any husky.
I do want to take you to the festival next year.
I'm down.
Are you into, like, I took, like, probably 30,000 steps each day.
Holy crap. Yeah, I mean, I don't mind doing the steps. I'll do it, man. Look, if I'm in the situation, I'll do it. But I'm more of a Coachella guy. You know what I mean? I watch it on the TV.
You take him to Coachella and then you take him to, like, a church retreat.
I'm down.
I remember church retreats.
Big revival night.
Yeah, you take me to a festival, take him to a revival. Yeah.
The thing about church retreats, I remember every time there was like a big festival like Coachella, they have to like flip their own version of it.
Yeah.
You know, Churchella, like Halloween, Hallelujah nights, you know, like they always try to remix it, you know? You don't gotta just do your own thing, man.
Exactly. I mean, they're thinking like, how do we, you know, gather the youth? This is what's in, the kids like this, so let's give them the bootleg version. I know.
Yeah, but do they ever like, are they ever like, okay.
It worked on me. Hallelujah night? Is it Halloween? Yeah.
You know, Disneyland used to try that too.
What?
Disneyland was trying like Hallelujah Nights for Halloween for a while.
What, like a week?
That's yeah, because their whole thing was like, I guess, kind of the less darker side of things, you know, more happy, because it's the happiest place on earth. It's not like the spookiest place on earth.
Right.
But anyways, good times. We stayed at a nice place with a pool, resort-y kind of vibes. You know what I mean?
Sounds amazing.
Anderson was DJing all over the place.
Right.
Tagging along. Busta Rhymes popped out on a set. Freddie Gibbs popped out on a set. Cordae popped out on a set. He had like surprise guests back to back.
Yeah.
That was dope.
I just don't trust myself. If I go to a festival, there's a part of me that still wants to get bent, bro. Mentally melt, bro. You know what I mean?
Your mouth movements, I could tell what substance you would want to be on. Dude.
I just want a cocktail of everything, man, you know?
Would you ever go with your kid?
See, why would you? Yeah, I would go with my kid. My kid, grown up, you mean?
No. Oh, you mean like right now as an infant? Yeah. I did see a family with a baby at the festival.
Yeah.
That's
not a good look.
It's not a family-friendly event.
Yeah, yeah.
It's blazing hot in the desert.
Oh, yeah, that's true. That's true.
But to be fair, the event you took your baby to wasn't a family-friendly event.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, I would. I would have to discuss it with my wife, and also just like how thick are the plumes of whatever that's out there, you know? But besides that, I just don't trust myself. I don't know if I could do a sober festival. I love getting lost in a sea of people by myself, like away from all my friends, just melting, bro. You know, I like that feeling.
I really did it sober. And it was really, I don't know, like I just it felt
surrounded
weird.
By two maniacs in completely different ways.
Why, you think that's crazy to do the festival sober?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh. Were you on anything last year? You seem chill. Shrooms. Oh, really?
A little bit of alcohol.
You seem like pretty regular.
That was good. I mean, I didn't.
So you,
I didn't take the whole like, you know, the shroom thing.
So while watching Blackpink, you were like, I need to do shrooms right now.
I mean, you know, the people that I was with were doing it, so I was like, I'll take some. But I didn't do a lot because I was scared. I was nervous. I was gonna get lost.
Mm.
Yeah, you don't get lost at a festival.
Dude, I'd even think about that. Could you get lost?
Yeah,
bro, it's easy to get lost.
Yes,
and there's like barely any service.
Mm-hmm.
You're in the desert. Nah, man. I don't know about all that.
Let's all go together next year.
I'm flat-footed. I don't know if I can survive out there.
Let's all go together next year, man.
I'm down. Let's do it.
Yeah. Who did you see anybody on the lineup this year that you wanted to see?
Honestly, if I'm not going and I see that list, it's so overwhelming. Before, like, years ago, I would go through it and comb through it. You know, like, I'd be like, oh, man, these guys are going to be here. Now I'm just like, oh, that's cool. That's crazy. But I'm not going to be there, so I don't care, you know?
You know what's funny? Last year, when we all went to Coachella, he was stayed back and he had a show.
Mm.
But he had a show recently too.
Oh yeah. Is that what's happening right now?
What?
The overlap.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not going to Coachella because I'm
like
own
revenge.
Show.
I'm gonna do it. Yeah.
Flo-cella. Exactly. Yeah. No, but I want to go. I would like that, man. I would appreciate that. I want to check it out.
No, but you also, you know, it was like a eventful show.
It was an eventful show, you know. Yeah. We briefly talked about it. I proposed to my guy. Oh. You know, I did the ring thing.
Oh,
did
we talk about that?
No, we didn't.
We didn't talk about it last episode?
You didn't ask him.
I
don't want
to bring it up. You know?
Yeah, let's share that real quick.
I
so
want to bring it in. That's not something to bring up.
Bring up. There was a rap show a few weeks ago that you were performing at with JL, the Year of the Ox.
Yeah.
And what did you do?
So, you know, I married Donna through paper really quickly, you know, at a Korean restaurant. But I never got her a ring. So this past trip to Virginia, I went ring shopping.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. While she was sleeping, I took a dental floss and wrapped it around her finger to get the ring size. How do you ask a girl for the ring size without making it obvious you're getting her a ring? You have to think about that.
I think you gotta like let her put your fingers in your mouth and you hold your lip and you go to a ring store and you're like, this is right there. I'm kidding. So did you really do this dental floss thing? Because this is romantic, actually.
I mean, she's a heavy sleeper, bro. It kind of scared me a little bit. Just like, what could you sleep through? You know what I mean? Because I'm literally, What, getting it on is easy, but then you got to tie a knot and then pull it off. You know, it's like a loose
you
tube.
You got to tie the knot.
You have to, man. It had to be accurate. You
tie
you know?
The knot to tie a knot. You could just do this, and then you can like mark, and then just.
Oh, like, I didn't even think about
you
that.
Like tied a knot.
No, I tied a knot and then and I pulled even make it off. Sense. How did I went finger fishing, bro? I was trying to get it off.
Why are you lying about this?
No, I'm serious.
Wait, so you did that? Yeah. You went to the ring store. You get a ring.
Well, yeah,
I got it was a big ring too.
We we discussed what kind of design she wanted. I didn't get the one that she got. She wanted. I got her a tear shaped one. It just spoke to me, bro.
Yeah, good.
All the tears that get I caused her. You
thing
know?
That she didn't ask for.
Yeah. There's diamonds around the band, isn't there?
Yeah, 79 chingu. You know what I mean?
Okay,
for friend. Mm. And yeah, no, she deserves it. You know, like you know Donna when I was back in the day, Highland Park days. She held me down. She was that girl that bought me every meal,
yeah.
Gas everywhere, drove me everywhere. And when we broke up first, I was like, damn, I put her through so much. I never really got to, you know, pay her back. That was always in the back of my mind. And I don't know. She came back into my life. It's a beautiful thing, man.
You saw that picture I sent you of us, right?
Yeah.
It's so crazy. Yeah, I'm going to send it to Alex.
Legend has it. You got a bigger face than me.
Does that mean you're going to do a... like a ceremony? Like a-
yeah, we want to do a ceremony, but, you know, Don and I are discussing. It's like house or ceremony, you know? Ceremony's cool, but if I'm going to do that, I want to do it at home with the family and make it kind of grand over there. You yeah. know, there's like that dual coast situation, too. Are we going to do it here? And it torn up some, man. You know what I mean? That's crazy.
But she really...
Yeah, who is the ceremony really for? Do you guys, if y'all both don't really...
If anything, we'll do like a party. You know what I mean? We already did the ceremony. I already did the. I
just save the money and buy some Bitcoin, bro.
I want you to do the celebration because I want to do a speech.
Do you?
Yeah, and I want you to do a speech as well.
I'm not doing a speech.
Come on, Rick.
So we could like compete? Over
no,
who had
it's not
speech?
A competition.
I've seen what happened at Zoe's.
It's not a competition.
These two were competing and seeing who had the better.
I do feel like Rick would kill a speech.
Speech compete? Yeah.
I might do a good speech, but.
Come on.
So he wants cool. you to get married just so he can do a speech.
I need stage time.
Do you like weddings, though?
Not really.
I love weddings, man.
I feel like you've been asked to be a groomsman.
Like 3 times.
Yeah.
And all the weddings failed.
What do you mean? They got a divorce?
Yeah.
Damn.
Are you serious?
I feel like I'm a bad omen, dude.
Don't get him as a groomsman.
Nah. You can do a speech, though. You know? I love weddings.
I don't want to be a groomsman, man.
I love weddings because, especially back in VA, you drink and get drunk with family members that you never thought you'd get drunk with. Mm. You see, like, the drunk side of, like, your como or, like, your great aunt that you've never seen.
Eh, not interested.
Oh, oh, here's a picture of you and me, Rick.
Damn.
I think this was about maybe 15, over 15 years ago. Yeah. This could be 20 years ago.
That's crazy.
We must
Rick,
have been-
like, literally looks like a turtle.
I look like Leo.
Yeah, this is the turtle when they take off the eye mask, bro.
Bro, that was the risk back in the day, trying to look like that. You have to balance the chin damn, height, bro. You know what I'm saying? If your chin goes a little too high, you expose the neck too
Rick
much.
Rick kind of looks like a K-Town goon. You could be.
Nah,
you know,
I look like
that
the
would
pawn.
Press you a little bit.
I look like
you
the
look
pawn.
Like a youth pastor. That's yeah. like half still doing meth and half recovered, like
a Methodist pastor.
A Methodist.
I really wonder what year this was. Didn't you send me this?
I think that was Asian. No, that's the collaboration battle.
How long do you think this was ago? Like
2007.
Damn, that's almost 20 years ago. Yeah, we've known each other for like that long too. I think
you guys known each other like a couple years before for sure.
Yeah, man, I win.
Yeah, Rek had that long hair.
He had long hair?
Yeah, you could tie it in the
oh,
back.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I look like a maniac.
He was like a goon with long hair.
What?
I told you. I'm not going to repeat the question, but repeat the story. You called me the F word 37 times the first time we met, man. Froze me.
Out of love.
Nah, man.
Every time I go visit New York, I hang out with Rek. He'd be tossing trash cans
yeah.
at bank windows, bumping into Korean fobs and yelling, Sekya! That's doing
just
awesome.
Scared me just now, dude. All I'm a different person.
Dude, I miss New York. We should do a New York trip.
Yeah.
You know, you guys been recently, right? You've been recently.
Yeah, but I love New York. We got to get back. Rek doesn't even care for New York.
I heard
anymore.
It's completely different now.
I just went.
Yeah.
Rek used to do things he does in video games now. He's like shooting up places, you know. Yeah, breaking boxes, stealing coins like Sonic and
of rage.
Yeah, streets of rage.
Absolutely, man.
Yeah, man. I don't know, but this is for the better. Rek has really come into. He's become a peaceful man.
I feel good, man.
Yeah. Bro,
this year's been a wild ride.
What's been up,
man?
There he is. This was even, like, we might have even wrecked a little before this, I think.
You look older in this picture than you do.
Yeah, I do.
Who is that?
That's J. Key Cho.
Oh, J. Key.
Yeah, Righteous Eats. Bonk. There he is. Used to manage Rek. Yeah.
You know what, man?
What?
Right now, these days, the temperature that I'm at.
Oh, hold on. Let me just share this real quick.
What's going on? Do you guys have these pictures just loaded up?
I don't know.
What's going on?
This is Rek in his fifth grade yearbook. This is fifth grade, right?
Yeah.
Fifth grade yearbook, and they ask a quote. 15 years from now, I will be, and he answered, a Korean rapper.
That's crazy. That face. Were you rhyming at that time?
Look at me. I'm living the dream.
Wait. What grade is that?
Fifth grade.
Fifth grade. I will tell you,
I wasn't sure I wanted to be a rapper at that age.
I didn't know what rap was in fifth grade, bro. That's crazy. Were you freestyling? Like, you weren't doing ciphers and stuff like that by then?
I don't even think I was at that point.
It was just a funny quote?
You were listening to rappers, though.
Yeah.
And just idolizing.
Yeah.
Not even a rapper, huh? A Korean rapper.
Yeah, that's so specific. Not even a rapper.
I think back then too, like growing up, it's like we had like Korean pride.
Oh hell yeah! Look at your akarima, bro.
Oh, so you were on the AZN pride at fifth grade?
Yeah,
it's pretty early.
Yeah,
it's a lot of pride for a boy.
Right. Let me ask you a specific question, real quick.
What?
Those glasses.
What, bro?
Are those frames from
No, those I don't lenses, know.
Hold on.
I can't confirm. Bro.
Those lenses, did it have a greenish tint reflection?
No.
You don't know what I'm talking about?
No, he came into the green a lot later.
Yeah. It was pretty green.
Everyone who wore glasses had those frames.
I think those had like a little bit of like, you know, the turquoise shell.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah, there he is.
Oh, man.
That's our Rek. Well, how does it feel, man? You did it. You're here now, sitting before us, and you are a Korean rapper.
Hell yeah.
Because you're not even just a rapper. You've also gone to Korea, put out an album in Korea. You are a Korean rapper.
I am. I'm going back to Korea next month.
What?
Okay.
You dropping these, really?
Yeah, why?
I don't know. I just feel like
I'm always here with you, bro.
All right, man. Because, you know, Dumb's busy these days. JL's gone. No one want to ask me about that.
You have
dude?
A son, bro.
He's like, I miss my friends. And we're like, bro, you have a baby. Yeah. You got to take care of.
You have a son that
it's
needs
it's important to have we time too, bro. You know what I'm saying? It's important to get away from the family and neglect your son a little bit so you can hang out with friends.
How much do you really miss your boys? Because it has been a while. And
I'm not going to lie.
We hung out yesterday.
Yeah, we did.
And even at night, we played a little.
Yeah, we did. You know, I just...
Mobile gaming without Dumb.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I just feel like, Dumb, you're too busy these days.
Hey, you need to go to Korea. You guys will do a family trip or something.
Oh, that'd be fun.
Because you could do content out
there,
too.
We speak of all these plans, but it never comes into fruition.
Well, that's on you, bro. I'm down for the plan.
How many Thanksgiving dinners do we talk
about? I mean, you get in your 30s and plans are just, you don't
do
plans.
Is this a theme of the episode?
What? Washed?
Our friendship is coming over. To an end. Yeah. It's the end of an era.
It's the beginning, finale. Of the end.
Well, I'm ready to move on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What?
No. I think you should go to Korea. We're going to be there too. I'm going to be there.
Jeez. See, this is exactly what the hell I'm talking about.
We made separate plans.
Really?
Yeah.
And it just kind of converged.
Everybody's
like that?
Going.
All right, I'll go. I heard
you should go.
I want to go. I got a lot of work to do there, baby.
You could take like a week away from your kid, right?
You can't go to Korea for a week. Are you kidding me, bro? A week trip to Korea is like
no. You could do
foreplay, bro.
Yeah, nah. I'll tell you what though. I think I will have a kid in 5 years.
Where does no, that I come mean it. From, bro?
I'm no. Clip it. I've been thinking about it a lot.
Okay. Did I inspire you at all?
Did that inspire part you of that bit? And just part of a lot of things I'm thinking about.
Yeah. It's not a lot of things required to think about making a kid. It's like it's love, man. Like what are the factors that you're thinking about?
No. I mean, it's not just like a partner that I have in mind to have a kid, but I've realized like I do want a kid.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I don't know how I'm going to get there.
Yeah, I hear what you're saying.
But I think
I want to go to Korea. I don't know how I'm going to get there either. Dude. You know what I'm saying? Like, I get it.
I don't know how I'm going to get there, but I'm going to figure it out.
Yeah.
And I'm going to have that kid.
That's cool. The fact that you have that, like...
What are you laughing about?
You have that scheduling in the back of your mind.
Stupid. Why is that stupid?
Rick, do you think you're going to have kids, man? Yeah, I want all of you guys to have kids by the next 5 years.
We're literally at the age...
I'm not having a kid. I'm not a follower.
You're going to have a kid, bro.
We're literally at the age where it's not crazy to have a kid.
No, we're late. What do you mean?
Yeah. I'm going to be an old dad.
We're not going to be that old. Not as old as Robert De Niro.
We're going to be pretty old.
We're going to be those dads where a kid's going to like college and we have like white
hair. I'll be 60 when my son's 20, bro. That's old.
You'll be 60 when your kid's 20. That's not too bad, I think.
That's not too bad.
Honestly, man.
That's why... Taking care of the body is like super important now. Because now I'm thinking of longevity for real, you know?
Yeah.
I see kids and I'm like, they're so cute and everything, but
yeah.
I'm not like,
yeah,
in a rush or like,
you know,
feel like
I
need to have kids. I need to.
That's that second son. That's that younger sibling mentality. I think because the young already got that like legacy thing out the way. You guys are just coasting.
Yeah. We can coast.
You guys could coast.
But everyone can coast.
No, we can't, man. I couldn't. Yeah, my bloodline would have died, bro, with me. I can't let that happen.
So what happens if you're...
I created a king,
Does your sister not want kids?
I mean, she may or not, you know.
Okay.
She's talking to her girlfriend, about it, so I don't know.
Would they do like a surrogate situation?
All I know is my sister would make an incredible mom, man. Mm. She's amazing. I get the hosting like bug from her, like that. Mm. Oh yeah, she goes overboard though. Like I'll bring the sliced fruit out, but she'll be like, and give it to you.
Rickley parties, you know, after parties that go from like 2 a.m. to 5 p.m. You might get a fish broth right in your mouth. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I think the last time we hung out at his crib, we had a meal and then everyone left and we were still eating at his crib afterwards.
Man. This man can make some mean broth, I'll tell you that.
Let's shift gears real quick, guys.
Yeah.
As a rapper, Korean rapper, I'm loving what's going on in hip hop right now, bro. Can we talk about it for a brief second? You guys don't like what? Are you guys too cool for rap now?
No,
are you guys not hip hop anymore?
Nah, we love rap.
Dude, the battle era is back. People are chopping at people's. All
right, relax, dude.
All right, I'm just saying, Rick, this doesn't tickle you a little bit?
Honestly, I don't care.
Wow.
Dude, that's wild.
I mean, I listen to it and I'm like, oh, cool.
I memorized all three, bro.
But it ain't like back in the day when I was like, oh, who's winning, Jay-Z or Nas, or, you know, like,
yeah,
State Prop versus the Locks.
I do feel like it's not dropping like fast enough and not like hard enough.
Mm.
And like really focused.
Like we grew up when Eminem was just destroying them. Like their whole careers, but
I know. What's that thing that they say, like when you smoke when you smoke drugs and you're trying to chase that first high, that dragon or whatever? That's what that was. I'm getting that glimpse right now. Like, you're right, these battles. But, you know, back in the day, too, like, Tupac hit him up.
Oh, yeah, like, fucking Tupac.
Yeah. Tupac was, like, not even funny or clever with his disses. It's a pretty direct calling it out.
You have sickle cell, you know?
But I will kill you.
Here's what I think's happening. Like, I do love all the diss tracks coming out. Yes. You know, J. Cole, Kendrick, Drake.
Yeah.
And I think Drake is winning because he probably is the funniest out of the three.
Facts.
If you're hanging out with him, like him, Kendrick, and J. Cole, he's probably the best roaster.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, his diss tracks are the most focused and direct. That's why I like him. You know what I mean?
Yeah, no, they're funny, but they're vicious too. And they're true, like, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, what he did to Meek Mill.
Right. I don't know, man. I haven't seen anything
that J. Cole or Kendrick has done on that level at all yet.
Mm. You know what is ruining these diss tracks for me?
What?
Are the
J. Cole's apology?
That and the explanations of the lyrics.
Oh my God.
You know, the rap genius correspondent breakdowns of the lyrics.
Screw that.
He said this and he meant that. Oh, brother. Oh my God.
I think like the people describing like what they meant, I bet Kendrick's like, nah. That's not what I meant at all.
You ever see those colorized syllable like displays?
Yeah.
Where it shows the lyrics and the sounds and all that?
They're trying to like, some of them are reaches. You know what I mean?
I don't think he meant that for real.
Like, I just think he just meant the direct first thing you think of when you think of that line.
Can I get serious for a second? You know what's kind of scary?
That was the most serious I've seen you be, but okay.
You know what's kind of scary?
What?
The fact that I can't tell if a new song is AI or not does not sit well with me.
What are you scared of?
I'm scared that, well, I mean, it's inevitable that anything that's creative, voice, digital, visual... Our time is limited now. I really do think that. The new diss song that just came out today by Kendrick, I thought it was good. It's not even real, bro. It's not even real. So if you can't differentiate real and fake, right now in courts, like irrefutable evidence is surveillance footage, right? But once you can't tell if surveillance footage is real or not, where are we headed as a world?
I like how this worry came from diss tracks. Like, I'm worried about the world.
Yo.
Like, this thought came to your mind from AI diss tracks. Wow. Just, you know. No, I feel you, though. It is scary, and it's kind of messed up. There's going to be a lot more popping up and bigger worries than just fake diss tracks.
Yeah.
You know,
I heard about those AI scams. Did you hear about that? Where, like, someone is taking someone's voice. Like, Grandma, I got into a car accident. Could you Venmo me some money?
Yeah.
And it's the grandchild's voice.
My grandma would never be able to use Venmo to begin with.
Wait, can you continue that conversation?
That's it. Come on.
What do you mean? Son, what do you mean? Where are you? Are you hurt?
Grandma, I'm on 495.
I'll send some money.
Yeah, exactly. And yo, people are getting got, dude. People are getting got. That's crazy
to me.
It's
sad. It's messed up.
Yeah, man.
Because the ones that are most susceptible to these scams are the grandmas.
Come on, dude.
I don't think my mom would ever be able to send any money, though.
I don't know if anyone's like me. I go on a binge, bro. I go to YouTube, and I love watching scammers getting got, dude. There's like YouTube channels just built just for that, where they call scam centers in India. And then he has like cameras already set up. They have police coming in. I love, you know what? Screw that. I love anything karma based videos, bro.
That's a good genre.
Great genre. Like Karen's getting, you know, karma'd out, or like people who are violent, but then like the street justice comes in and he gets killed on screen.
Oh my gosh.
No, but you know
Relax,
what I mean?
Relax, bro.
Yo, I love karma based videos, bro.
I could see you doing that kind of content.
I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, I did
you
too.
You do too, right?
I love
revenge. Koreans love revenge.
We do love revenge.
I could see you creating some of that kind of content.
Bro.
What, revenge? Where you kill somebody?
No, not kill. Not to that extent.
Yeah.
Extended. I was like, right. Am I doing say now?
Yeah. No.
But like, you pulling up on somebody because they did something wrong,
Did you see that video where like some internet guy was like talking crap and he found him? The guy that was talking crap in the comment section, he found him in real life at a mall.
But that's a little OD. The dude is just trolling. It's not a huge deal.
See, I'm a little more sensitive than you, bro.
You do got like bounty hunter vibes.
I collect IP addresses, bro.
You got bounty hunter vibes.
You don't have a VPN protector and you're talking about me.
What are you pulling up over here?
Today there was protests at O'Hare Airport and the Golden Gate Bridge and other places, and they block traffic. So my question is, how would you guys feel if you had somewhere to be and there was a protest? Would you guys be calm, or would you know what would you guys do? Because this boils my blood sometimes.
This. Okay,
Well, what would you do, Alex?
Alex was always a Republican.
I mean, regardless of what they're actually protesting, you know, like there are causes that you can support, but like, you know, like, sure, like, can you take some time, you know, out of your day? It's just, I just feel like if I was like at one of the first cars getting blocked and like there was all this pressure and people were just yelling and stuff and like smacking the hood of your car, like, that would be scary.
What if your parent was sick?
Yeah.
And you have to deliver some medicine.
Oh, someone's getting run over.
But I will say this. I agree with you, and it's annoying what they're doing.
Yeah.
But
what?
It's working. That protest is working because we're pulling it up and we're talking about it.
I'm talking about how much I mean, hate it.
You were there, weren't you? He wasn't even at Coachella, dude. It was a fucking alibi.
No, I wasn't there. I'm just saying, like, people are talking about it. Like, sometimes, you know, protests, you got to, that's the whole idea of a protest. Yeah. You're getting people's attention somehow.
Hold on. Let's see if it's working or not. You're right. They're protesting. What are they protesting against?
I don't know. That's a good point. Yeah. Yo, I guess we are talking about the cops.
We're talking about it. We're talking about the headline. I'm talking about how much I despise these people, because if you think about it, right, break it down. Okay, their cause is they're doing this. Why? They're not trying to inconvenience people, but by inconveniencing, it's to
make
headlines.
They'll find out the
cause,
and then the people will be like, "That cause."
Right. That's what I'm saying.
Oh, you think it would backfire?
It'll backfire against them. You kidding me? Yeah. Speaking of karma videos, I love videos of seeing people get out of their cars and just throwing these guys off to the side. It is, oh, man.
that's the content you love?
You don't understand. Right now, I'm outputting so much wholesome content because of Kaden. Bro, I'm boiling inside. I'm intaking a lot of darkness.
There's
bro.
A lot of, I feel like there's a lot of rage-inducing content these days. About even like you see that thing about the squatter.
Oh my God.
Yeah, somebody's trying to evict somebody off their property and then they got arrested for like changing the locks or something.
That is infuriating.
I saw actually a karma video for that. You know what they do? Instead of taking the doors off, they took 4x4s and nailed them in so they can't get out, bro. Now yous can't leave. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, it's crazy.
All right. I'm sorry. I love it.
Yeah. Have you been in any situation recently where now you're very protective of your kid, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Somebody's doing something annoying or messing with your kid where you step in and that fatherly instinct has kicked in?
I'm naturally like that with people I love. You know what I mean? I'm usually just like very like, my head's on a swivel when it comes to Donna and stuff like that. So I'm actually trying to lessen that a little bit.
Has there been a moment like somebody actually bumps the stroller?
Not bump, but you know, you see me having a stroller, right? You know there's a kid in there. Why, if you're less than 15 feet away, would you spark that Marlboro light up, though?
Oh,
you know what I'm saying?
How about this?
Like, what? Yeah.
You're on a plane.
Yeah.
And your kid's just crying. And then a guy just turns around. He's like, he's sitting in front of you. He goes, yo, tell your stupid kid to shut the
yeah, what happens then?
I mean, I honestly think, well, you want me to give you the podcast answer or the realistic answer?
Give me the real answer.
The real answer is pretty people around will already hear that and then they'll get got already. That's plain justice. I've seen it happen. Mm. You know, like honestly, at that moment, I'm not going to lie to you. I'm very non-confrontational. Like, even if that happens, I'm going to give you my honest answer. I'm not going to swing it. I'm not going to jeopardize the flight of us getting kicked off. Mm. Not in a cowardly manner. I just don't want to pour gas on the plane.
Man.
You know what I mean?
What happens when you get off the plane?
Oh, he's dead. he's dead.
Plane won't be the only thing on the runway.
No.
I think I've seen everybody grow up in that sense. You know, Rek used to get into a lot of things.
Yeah.
You know, we used to be at public settings and, you know.
You think about the ROI, bro. You know what I mean? Yeah. That's what it is.
Yeah. It's not, no, I'm saying, like, it's just not worth it for me.
Yeah.
I remember the last thing I almost got into in K-Town. There was like these, you know, me and my boy were just sitting. We were with like a couple of girls. And there's three drunk dudes. And then I just knew they just wanted to start something.
Mm.
So they come over. He's like, yo, aren't you that dude who used to stream? And I was like, yeah. Sits down next to me, mad drunk. And like, and then I'm like, yo, I didn't ask you to sit, you know?
Wait, did you say it in that tone?
No, I said that exactly in that tone.
Okay, you were annoyed.
Come on, man. I'm not, I'm very, I don't start fights at all.
Yeah. No,
I'm not going to just,
right.
You know, let someone disrespect me.
Right.
So I was just like, yeah, like, I was like, you know, and then he started wilding.
Mm.
His friends started wilding. They're screaming and shouting.
Yeah.
And we're just like.
Small d- syndrome. You know, it happens. Yeah.
Right? I hate the drunk, uninvited person who joins the table.
Yeah.
Bro, I can't stand that, man.
I love it.
That's a part. That's the thing about K-Town. Like, it. Those people have ruined a lot of my favorite spots.
Yeah.
Because there'll be people I know.
Yeah.
But, like, I'll go out and have dinner or drinks with, like, my group of friends.
Right.
I'll run into somebody that I may know.
Yeah.
But they'll just sit down.
Oh, my God.
It's like, yo, we'll have our time. 100%. We'll have our time right now.
We're in that uncomfortable position where we have to, like, let it be known, bro.
It's like no nunchi.
No nunchi.
You know what I mean? Like, this. I'm in a dinner meeting right now.
Yeah. Yeah.
Actually, it's not even a dinner meeting. But still.
I feel like there have been times where I might even have been that person.
Oh,
but
yeah.
Then if I recognize it, if I even see a little bit, I'll be like, oh, yeah, I gotta, you know.
For sure.
I'll be out. Whatever.
For sure. You know? I mean, people that lack that much social... I mean, you know how when we talk about old KSA parties, we talk about the ones that work the hardest, the squarest ones are usually like the wildest, sloppiest ones at after party?
Mm-hmm.
I kind of noticed that the ones that we know that are like that, they're like super hard workers. You know what I mean? Like powerful, like business people during the day. So when they're kind of off like that, you gotta just let them have it, man.
Yeah.
You know? It's just... the sloppiness definitely did ruin the vibe of K-Town. We got to a lot of almost fights in the past because of that.
I saw like a tweet... I
mean, but that's everywhere with alcohol.
Yeah. Nah, but with Koreans, there's that seniority effect that's like playing too in a weird way. There's a lot of physical, like... non-consensual touching going on, you know, especially when the drunk, and also
a lot of hyunging,
a lot of majority of them too, they're on the ya-ya, right? So they got that breath, you know, they got that breath, bro.
Yeah.
No.
There's like the drunk, like hyung, like over your neck.
And the crazy thing is he's not even trying to sun you, like he's really showing genuine love.
Yeah.
That's why the fight starts like that, because you're getting offended from the recipient side. And he's like, what?
I'm just glad that I've never seen any of us try to hyung anybody.
I will never hyung like anyone younger than me.
Even if they're young as they have mad respect for you and they're like, yo, hyung, blah, blah. It's like, I'm just like, yo, you don't got to do all that.
Bro. Yeah.
Yeah.
I used to be like,
I'm a person. Like,
until they hit you with that good hyung. You know what I mean? That good, like really, like, oh, respect.
What are you talking about, bro? Wait, you're just sucking your
good young, like,
you gonna diddy them?
That did sound sus. What I meant is like, no, like
me too.
No, like they show you mad respect and like just like
stop bowing.
No, I mean when they're giving
two heads,
they're giving man.
No. We might have to edit that part out, bro.
Keep it in.
No, I mean like when they show you mad respect, you know, it just feels
how
good.
Mad, bro?
It's just like when they're giving you...
I know what you mean.
Hey, but hey, let's talk about... I've been seeing you getting your name dropped a lot by Bobby.
Oh, yeah. I was going to say that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like a year or two years ago, we're all like, you know, that's a hyung, like we all love him, like
God, yeah.
Yeah, like how do we get near him?
But you know, let's be real, he is dropping his name a lot, but mad unnaturally. My friend Dumbfoundead, he never says your name normally, bro.
I feel like every time he says my name, it's always in it, like he just met me or something.
Yo, yeah. It's like a baby's book, Dumbfoundead.
Yeah, it's like he's not sure what your name really is. Yeah. Like,
you know what I'm talking about, right?
I do feel that.
What happened with this influx, dude? Like, how did that happen?
Nah, he's really like a good hyung, you know?
Yeah,
he will
go
grab dinner.
You showed him mad respect or what?
He's that good, yo.
He's that good, yo. For people who don't even know what hyung means, they probably think it's like a sus word now.
Yeah,
they're just like, what does hyung mean?
I want that hyung. Shut the
So explain what hyung is.
No, explain it.
We're talking about sus stuff, but
yeah.
Every time that we're like in a group together with me, Dumb, and Bobby, Bobby's always trying to get Dumb to kiss him. On the lips.
Bro.
What?
Can I say it or no? I can't share
what?
It. You did kiss him, bro.
Who, me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I did.
He did.
Hey, Bobby. He did do it. Bobby asked you to kiss him on the lips. You kiss him on the lips.
He committed. He really did commit. I couldn't do it, man.
I know the funny
thing. He really gave him the good yum.
And you know what, though? I do it out of just for the bit, because for the funsies.
No, of course.
You didn't commit to the
bit. I do it more so because he doesn't want to do it.
Why would I want to do that?
I don't know, because it's...
You know, I don't want to kiss anybody that I don't want to kiss.
Yeah.
He just wants some smooches from his favorite thong zang.
Yeah, exactly.
That sounds...
He's not your good young unless you kissed him in the lips, bro. Let's be honest.
I'm not kissing Bobby, bro.
What's the story? Can you tell the story?
Shut your dumb...
It's just a random night out. And, you know, Bobby's very... Okay, let me ask you something.
Bobby will... Here's the thing.
Yeah.
Bobby will do whatever it takes for the laugh. Yeah.
And so to make you feel uncomfortable.
So we're at dinner, right? If we're just having dinner and, like, we're sitting by the window where it's see-through and Bobby walks in, he'll look at us and he'll be like this and then walk out and just, like, look like he's leaving. But he'll go around the corner... For like 5 minutes just for the bit. Like so we believe that he left.
Yeah.
And he'll come back 5 minutes later. I'm like, you were just standing there. You were just standing there out of sight.
Right.
So he commits to the bit. And I think what Rek was doing, like Rek noticed when Bobby was like, Popo.
Yeah.
Like as a joke.
Yeah.
He countered.
And I was like, nah, I'm not gonna kiss you. And then Rek was like, and he was like, Popo to Rek. And Rek was like, all right, Popo. And he kissed him.
Go.
He kissed him. And I was like shocked. Yeah. But like Rek was
both Rek and Bobby, they come from that same cloth of committing to the bit.
Rek was all about committing to the bit.
He commit to the bit. Yeah. I mean, he commits to the bit too.
Oh,
hard.
Yeah, dude. Oh, tongue.
Seems like you're the only one who doesn't commit to the bit.
Yeah.
You're not getting me to kiss Bobby,
He does the light bits, like the jokey bits.
Right.
He won't do the bit.
You're not getting me to kiss Bobby.
He won't do the bit.
Oh, but bro, just picturing Bobby looking at my direction going, Popo.
You're making it seem like it's like something you have to do. Like if
you got to do it.
You're making it seem
you
like.
You got to do it.
It's like if Snoop asks you to smoke a joint, you're like, I got to do it.
Yeah, you
if Bobby asks you to kiss him, you got to kiss him. Is that the same thing?
It's the same exact thing.
That's not good, yo.
Snoop's blunt is the same thing as Bobby's popo.
That's true, man.
It's a bobo popo.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Nah,
oh,
no,
my
it's
gosh.
Not the same thing. I commend you, though. I really commend you, man.
I mean, you know, if you're not gay, you do a little smooches with another man.
Yeah, bro. Come on.
I got handed to you. You did it.
Sounds like I achieved something.
You did.
You did. I mean, you earned my respect that night.
You got peer pressured into kissing Bobby.
Popo.
Oh, man. I don't know where I'm going now.
So, I mean, segue off that. What have you been up to? What have we all been up to? I feel like we don't
There's a lot of secrecy clouding right now.
Well,
I don't even know.
You're busy. You have a
My life is online. You could see everything. You know what I mean? So there's no updates for me. I'm updating you guys every day. I want to know what you guys are up to.
I want to get jacked. No, I want to get shredded.
Yeah.
Like Jake Gyllenhaal and Roadhouse shredded.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Even eating less Postmates and eating like getting groceries, I'm eating.
It's hard though, man. You know, there's like a body fat machine in my gym, and I'm at like 18%.
Are you serious?
It's good, but like this is to put in reference.
Yeah.
Jake Gyllenhaal in the movie Roadhouse is 5% body fat,
and that's what you want. You want that?
I mean, 5% is like
be
impossible.
Able to do laundry
not
on
impossible.
Your stomach,
but I do want 10 to 15% body fat.
What was Brad Pitt in Fight Club?
5%.
Come on,
that's 5%.
Can I be honest? You going to 10%, just go to 5, bro.
No, it's not.
If you're going to just go to 5, bro.
Right.
What does it take? What does it,
it
I mean,
takes
what kind
a
of
lot.
Sacrifice?
It takes a lot. You got to just eat the right amount of clean proteins.
Right.
No.
And it's not sustainable,
foods.
Right? Like,
hey,
they don't
do,
stay there.
Can you do like bibimbap? Is that bad?
It's not necessarily good for that.
Yeah, rice.
Because I'd be seeing your like healthy meals.
It's not
healthy, bro.
No, but one time a day. If it's one meal a day?
I think you're getting certain nutrients because there's a lot of veggies in it. But they're all like marinated with soy sauce and different marinades.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. I don't know.
That is true.
Rick, I you know that picture that we saw?
Yeah.
You were like really skinny in that one.
That was malaria. You know, that was due to, yeah, that wasn't
You look kind of unhealthily
yeah,
skinny.
Yeah,
yeah,
that was manorexic at that time. Dude. Really? That was bad. Yeah.
Manorexic.
You it had was, malaria.
I had malaria. I have stigmatism. I had insecurities.
It did look like some drug addiction stuff, too.
Nah, bro. No? It looked fentanyl-y, but it's not. I don't
fentanyl-y.
You know. Yeah.
You know. Yeah. You dressed the same, though. Yeah, like, I think hoodie. I've seen that hoodie, like, on you, like, a week ago.
Yeah, man, you know.
I feel like Rick has been dressing a little better.
I've been, you know what it is? I haven't been coming out. I've
maybe that is what it is.
Yeah. So when I come out, I'm like, what's the best thing? You know?
It's hard because I don't know. I've gotten really used to my slides and sweats. I've been like online shopping for stylish sweats.
Right. Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
And I should have never gave you money.
You know what kind of style I want to go into?
Yeah, I remember in the group chat recently, you were like, they were $70 socks. What the are you buying $70 socks?
They weren't $70. They were like $35 socks. It's not crazy.
Still a bit.
Is it?
That's a bit.
You did text me the other day and you were like, hey, you want to go shopping?
Yeah, but I wasn't trying to get $70 socks.
What made you think you just felt like shopping or what?
Yeah, I haven't shopped in a long time. I mean,
you know what's crazy? I had that feeling too recently. Remember the flea market? We like just barely missed each other. I was there like a couple minutes before.
Oh, you went?
I was like, I'm gonna pick up something.
Yeah,
you know.
I do feel like shopping is one of those things you do, but you don't talk about like the act of doing it. Like dudes aren't like, we're shopping right now. Like, or do they say that? Do they share that?
I mean, I just want to be like, yo, let's just go hit up some, you know, shops. So we're shopping. Oh,
cool. Now you just wanted to switch up the wording on that.
What?
Let's go hit up some shops.
Undercover yeah, cop.
What the
f-? No, because I'm just saying, like, when I shop, it's always like in between things, like right. In between activities.
Yeah,
shopping.
We never make shopping like a.
You know what I think is because you're like always driving around. I'm just usually like at the crib.
That's
so
true.
It's
that's
like
true.
A thing to go places, you know?
You're a roamer, you know?
Yeah,
and
you
as you
roaming.
Roam, you have opportunities to make little purchases. For us, we need to make it a little schedule.
Could I say shopping in LA is very inconvenient? Because when you go to a store that you like, there's maybe one or two other stores that are like decent around that shop. Or you got to go across town to another section with like three shops.
Yeah.
There isn't really one area that has like 10 shops you could hit at once.
Yeah. You don't go to a mall anymore, man.
Come on, man.
You graduated the mall.
What are you doing over there, bro?
Saying, you don't know Bloomingdale's anymore?
What are you doing?
No.
You doing Skechers? What are you doing, bro?
Yo, when I was in Thailand.
Doing Zoomies? You doing Zoomies? I'm in Zoom meetings. You're doing Zoomies, bro. What are you doing?
Damn. That was unnecessary, bro.
I'm sorry. Yeah. We're
hip hop guys in the mode right now.
We're riding diss tracks, you know. Dispatch. No, all
right. Nah, but you're right.
Yo, I think the last time I was here, I was talking about going to Thailand, which I failed that challenge, by the way, for the record.
We knew it.
Well, there was a lot of factors, all right? I got
Do you remember the challenge? Make how many tracks?
Oh, yeah. I forgot.
It was for like $12,000.
Bro,
it was
like, could you repeat?
It was for like $12,000. It was for like a lot of money.
No, it wasn't $12,000. It was for like
$1,200.
It was like $1,200. But then if you lost, you owed me like $100 or $200.
I owe you $200.
Yeah, $200. But what was the challenge? You had to make 20 songs?
13 album tracks?
No, like 30 songs.
30 songs.
Oh, wait, it was 30 or 20.
You were confident you were going to write like 20 to 30 songs in like 4 weeks.
Well, yeah. Okay, I got there and then I didn't have an important wire. And I was asking,
an old wire.
No, straight up. And then,
the XLR excuse, huh?
And then it was like an old wire. And then, and then I get there and then we go to Vietnam out of nowhere because Zoe's in Vietnam. So me and Danny go there. I get back and then we hit up some like music festival in Pattaya, which is a whole different city. So, yeah, you're right. All right. But I wasn't mad at it.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah. They didn't have the wire in that whole southeastern country. There was no wire. It came down to the wire, I'll tell you that.
But nah. I did record an album.
You did, congrats. But
yeah, after that Thailand.
You don't owe me the 200, man.
After Thailand, I went to Korea. I saw you in Korea.
Yeah.
And then, yeah.
So you guys are just bumping into each other like this on some international trips without me? That's crazy. It is kind of crazy.
I was running into him a lot.
What a life you guys live. That's amazing, man.
Hey, you got a kid, though.
Mine's over.
Do you feel like this is when people have kids? No, hold on. When people have kids,
yeah,
nothing else really matters anymore. No, like feat or goal is as great as
feet.
No, feet matter.
This goal that you're trying to reach,
yeah,
it's not great as this child that you made.
Almost feels like, from what I'm hearing, everything else matters because he messes it. You know what I'm saying?
No, you know what it is, dude. The amount of importance remained the same. It's just kind of dampened a little bit. It's muted a little. Like, the volume's turned down a little bit.
Yeah.
I'm still aware. I still want to be... One thing I give myself credit for is, like, I'm still involved in everyone's life. Like, I bring Caden through. There's a lot of homies that we know that has a kid that you don't even see ever. Or them either. You know what I mean?
I'm not going to name any names. Yeah, Mikey, Fresh.
You know, but just... Because I think it's a choice that you make. Some family just, they shut off, you know, and they just kind of isolate themselves.
Yeah.
But I have, like, the coolest group of, like, people I know. I want Caden to kind of be familiar with that, you know?
Who?
You, come on, man.
Do you think when parents take their 2-year-old or 3-year-old on trips with them, it's because they can't get a babysitter, or they actually want their babies to experience
That's a good question, because it's not going to matter, bro. It's not going to matter.
Because they're like if they're like 4, maybe.
Because they don't remember things before a certain age, right?
That's another thing. I'm thinking about that. It's not only about memory. It's like, do they appreciate it?
I don't remember anything under the age of 9.
Under the age of nine.
When I have a baby, I'm gonna set up an incubator system, right? Where it's like just a warm pod.
Yeah.
And it's gonna have my face, like hologram, like digital.
Damn.
I'm just going to be talking to him, like, sing him to sleep.
Yeah.
So you're really planning to have a kid, like, way later than... Yeah. Because that technology...
No, I'll set it up.
That might be, like, 10 years away, though.
So you want a truly, like, hands-free baby. You don't want to...
You don't want to hold your baby, man?
And then there's going to be, like, a mouse wheel.
Yeah. Yeah, you don't know, man.
I think Rek would be a good dad, though.
I think all of us would be great dads.
I'm letting you know, bro. His baby's going to be like, can I play that next? Like, no! I still got to beat this level! I am a legend, and I am in a league of legends!
Dad, I need to make a call.
Dad,
I need the calculator, Dad.
I need to do my homework. Can I use your phone?
No! This is multiplayer!
They're counting on me!
What a way to tie it all back.
Bro. Oh, man. Yeah. That's cool, though. You could play video games with your kid.
Dude, I'm going to... Right? That's going to be... Aren't we excited, bro? Like, our nursing home, when we're older, right? And we're starting to get, you know... Our nursing home experience is going to be crazy.
First of all, if people don't know what you meant by this, they're just going to think you're talking about erectile dysfunction. So you probably should explain what you meant by that word.
I mean, that's going to happen, too.
Yeah, that's going to happen, too. So it makes sense.
It just means, you know, we're going to be decrepit.
Posture.
We're going to get weaker. We're going to become older men, right?
Yeah.
Like, our nursing home is going to be so fun, man. Recording studio. Hell yeah. LAN parties.
Recording studio.
You really think there's going to be a recording studio in your retirement home?
Come on,
you're
dude.
Not going to even want to rap, bro.
I mean, you know, I don't know. Do you guys feel that age? I still feel, I don't know, man. This beefing everywhere in hip hop, it just sparked a fire in me, bro. I'm telling you right now.
These diss tracks made you think about your future.
It's back, man.
How many times you masturbate to
Rick Ross joint?
Yeah.
Twice. Letting you know right now, nursing home experience is going to be
great. This is what I want to see for us when we're older.
Yeah.
And I think we have to start planting a seed now.
All right.
This is dead. I watch a lot of Korean variety shows, right? I want, like, An and Hyung, like, Knowing Bros for us. Like, I want just us to be on a show where we have a guest and we just play games and we go on trips. And
I'm going to entertain forever, bro. I'm down.
That sounds fun.
But, you know what I'm saying? And we're just, you know, we're getting older.
Isn't that what those guys did? Like in Korea?
That's literally all they do.
And yeah, Running Man, that's all. It's like she's doing fun stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, it's going to be cool.
How do we do that? How do we make that happen?
Yo, how do you fold your legs so high up here? That is crazy.
I didn't notice that. He tucked his leg under his armpit right now.
Have you seen Danny?
Yo,
yeah, Danny,
you're a Swiss pocket knife, bro.
So we have this friend named Danny.
Yeah.
Danny Chung.
Yeah, okay.
Very fashionable. We all know Danny. Right. He's wearing Rick Owens drip. Always taking photos on IG, like super fashionable, chrome hearts, yeah. Rick Owens.
Yeah.
But like, he'll do this trick where he sticks his leg behind his neck. Yeah.
What?
You ever see some Rick Owens boots behind the neck just hanging out like this? It's insane. I've never seen a more...
His legs just look like hockey sticks.
Yeah, I've never seen a more flexible dude with drip. It's crazy. It's insane.
Oh, he's foldable?
It's really uncomfortable to see, actually.
That's crazy. Yeah. Danny? Like what brought him to what was the setting for him to actually get down on the ground and show you?
He
guys
just wanted to brag that he's more flexible than us.
And you guys are talking about mentally.
It's crazy. I don't even think he stretches. There's no way he stretches. He always like 80% leather pants. There's no way he stretches. He's not stretchy.
Looks
pants.
Like a bag of bones.
Oh man.
Shout out Danny.
Shout out Danny, bro.
All right, what's grinding your gears
now?
What is grinding your gears?
I got a little hot take, man.
All right. Well, it's called Grinding Your Gears, the segment.
No, oh, this is called Grinding Your Gears? You going to take the Family Guy joint?
No, go ahead.
Bro, I am so over. I am done with Wagyu, bro. I'm
the
done
word
with,
or the actual type of meat?
The type of... Everyone has Wagyu.
I don't even know what it means, really.
It's like a type of... It's a cut. It's like a type of Japanese... Well, not only Japanese. Australia has it, too. It used to be like a very sought out... Rare, you know what I mean?
I'm not mad at Wagyu, man. I always order Wagyu. If they got the option, I'm getting the Wagyu.
Can you tell the difference between a good ribeye and a Wagyu?
I mean, just show me the certificate, and I'm, you know. No,
if someone brings out a perfect attendance certificate.
I do feel like all the Wagyus that I tried, it is legit good.
Every Korean barbecue right now has Wagyu, man.
It might be a scam.
How are you going to know? Yeah, if they bring the Carfax out, I'm
down. You know what they're sleeping on, though?
What?
I forgot what it's called. The Korean one.
Hanu. Hanu is supposed to be the
Hanu.
Come on, bro.
Because everybody's talking about the Wagyu. They're talking about the Kobe. But then what about the
right. Hanu?
The
Hanu. Right. The Koreans are coming,
The Koreans are coming,
baby.
The Koreans are coming, baby. With the Ha-old and in with the Hanu.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
We're coming. All right. Sorry about that.
You know Robert from Mama Lion?
Yeah.
He brought me and Kirby to fire Hanu spot. It's
really?
Like deep in the cut. No, in Korea.
All right, so what
and
are
you
talking about?
You could taste the quality that it was particular.
Oh, it was like the best Korean barbecue I've ever had.
I don't know if this is true, but apparently Korea has some of the top-notch beef cuts in the world.
Hanu?
In the world. I don't know if this is true. Alex, maybe you could look it up. Yeah. Are we ranked number one in beef? I don't know.
By the way, this is something that I know just from being an insider, but they don't actually export it at all.
What do you mean? They don't export
the Hanu.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So it's just in Korea. You can
it's just
get
in
it.
Korea. It's
something that only I knew about.
Oh, okay. Argentine beef. Like, I know my beef, man. I'm Korean. I'm Argentine.
He knows his beef. Oh, no, good.
That's true.
Bobby.
Oh, man. Okay, what's ranked number one beef?
It was Argentinian.
Argentinian beef. Okay. Yeah, I mean, are Koreans in the top 10? Oh, Wagyu's number two.
Three is
carne de acores.
It's Portugal.
Portugal, okay.
Portugal. You got Kobe.
Japan again with number four, Kobe.
Another Portugal with a different kind
another
of cow.
Portugal, Portuguese.
Yeah, we're not on the list.
Yeah, Portugal. Right.
Why are we hoping? Why are we hoping? Yeah, I was hoping
let's
to
just see if it's in the 9 or 10.
Hungary. Scotland.
Okay, we're not
again.
On the list.
Right, literally every country but ours.
Yeah,
that's fine.
Wow, I didn't even know that.
Yeah, right. This is a random list about rated best beefs.
It's fine. We're not on the list. It's okay. We can
live. any like TV shows or anything that you guys been watching? Movies.
I saw Civil War. I thought it was a fun ride. It's not like a deep movie or anything, but there's some like. Scary moments like if America were to be in a war, Oh, and you're driving through the country. It's fun. Lot of gun violence.
Right.
I was disappointed.
Oh, yeah. We saw it together.
It reminded me of your song, Homeland.
Why are you just going to erase me from your memories? Nah,
he does that.
Like, do I do that?
Eternal
spotless mind of me, bro.
You MIB does, bro.
I do forget sometimes.
There are so many times where he'd be like, hey, why don't you meet this person?
Right.
And then I'm like, I met him like 20 times.
No, you know why I forget? You know why I forget when I go to a movie with friends? Because a movie is a solo experience.
Right.
You're in the theater. You're in the movie. You're watching the movie. It's you and the movie. Right. That's why I don't like when people talk to me during the movie. This isn't a group experience. This is a solo experience.
I never talk to Dumb.
Yeah, yeah.
That's good.
Because I'm asleep.
Oh, we got to tell the story.
Yeah, go.
I got to tell it properly.
What?
Me and Rek.
Mm-hmm.
This was 5+ years ago. We're in New York City, right? And we have a night of drinking.
Yeah.
Just getting hammered till like 4 a.m. We go home. We wake up the next morning. It's the opening day of Black Panther.
Wow.
So we go to the city. We go to Black Panther Theater. It's packed.
I bet.
98% black people.
Yeah.
Me and Rek are sitting in this packed theater. Rek is hungover. He's sleepy.
Don't tell me he's snoring.
He started snoring 5 minutes into the movie. Loud. And I'm panicking because people, this is a moment, right? Yeah. Like Black Panther, that's borderline all black racist. Cast. Black superhero.
Yeah.
He's snoring, and I'm tapping this fool to wake up. And he wakes up for a second, and he's like, "Oh, Wakanda."
I literally did that.
Yeah,
you serious?
I literally did that. Every time I woke up, I was like, "Oh."
BX.
And I'm just like apologizing on behalf, like, you know, he had a long night. I don't know why I'm trying to explain during the movie. I was just like, he had a long night, blah, blah. But I kept waking him up. He kept falling back asleep every like 10, 15 seconds. It was like really embarrassing.
In my defense,
yeah,
as tired as I was, like, we literally didn't sleep. We literally just powered through it. I wanted to support so bad.
Right.
That I went under those conditions. And.
Yeah.
I always sleep in every movie. I slept through Everything Everywhere All at Once. Crazy Rich Asians. Okay.
All the Asian movies you've slept
through. I slept through everything.
Yeah.
All at once.
So if I'm racist, so be it.
No discrimination.
This is literally like Martin Luther King. I have a dream during movies.
Oh my god.
Wow.
He really has slept through everything. I think the pachinko premiere he slept through. He just slipped me through it all
the
time.
You know what it is, man? Theaters just make me feel so cozy.
Yeah. I'll be
loving the movie, dude.
Oh, really?
Like,
you can fall asleep to a movie you love?
Yeah, I love it, and I'm like, I'm literally pinching myself.
Oh,
I'm like
trying
I'm like, oh no, not now.
Nah, fatigue kicks me through indifference. Not because if I'm tired and I'm like yawning, right? Once like the trailers come on and I'm kind of hype, I don't know. I could fight through it. I would never. Could you, bro? The price of tickets right now.
It's so weird though because I'll fall asleep in a movie theater that's 2 hours long, but I'll binge a whole. K-drama for 15 hours.
That is wild.
I honestly do think they need to update the formats for K-dramas. I have actually heard complaints.
But any TV show.
No. I've actually heard complaints from like K-drama fans that the episodes are too long. And this isn't just coming from like non-viewers of K-dramas, but actual fans of K-dramas saying like it might be too long.
Man, who the fuck are these fans, bro?
Why you don't mind?
Are they
it's
Korean
perfect.
Versatile?
You don't mind it?
No, you want more.
Dumb, look at me.
Yeah.
It's perfect.
Yeah.
You think so?
And perfect length.
I mean, there are sometimes when
No.
Towards the end of the series where everything's kind of resolved and they kind of drag maybe last two episodes.
Yeah.
But other than that, yo, Koreans want like an hour and a half of content, bro.
Yeah, but what is
Koreans,
the
hardworking,
but what
giving
is,
you more and more.
What is the reasoning behind that? Do you think they're just trying to fill in the time slots of like the broadcast, or is it because people actually like the long formats?
Listen, Dumb, I don't know. I don't question it. You don't question a good thing.
I don't
thing.
Question it.
That's okay? true. I guess it's working.
It's
Keep
working.
Keep K-dramas long.
If anything, one thing they could work on is maybe shorten the recap from the episode before. You start episode 3.
No. Once you start shortening the recap, because every every next scene is a recap. You're right, I've seen them recap a recap. Yeah. Like, remember when I used to
remember when I used to remember?
They do put recaps throughout the whole thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They'll never let you forget. Just like the characters will never forget what they did to him.
That's true. Yeah. It's like, all right, he did slip him that thing.
Yeah. Ichima.
They are really good with the recaps.
No, come on.
Oh, it's true.
Yeah.
And I think that the reason why Korean content is so good is because they just make sure you understand everything. Mm. Like, they'll recap it, they'll explain it, and then they'll be like, on game shows, they're like a caption of what they're thinking and or why they said this
joke. You're talking about the pop-up stuff.
Yeah, everything is just so overly explained.
Dude, you're right. You're absolutely right.
But everyone gets it, you know?
Mm-hmm. You're so right, because after, like, I binge a Korean show, and then I watch, like, a stylized American show, and they don't explain it, I'm like, what's going on? Why are they not spelling it out for me?
And that's why that show, Devil's Plan, is so groundbreaking.
Right.
Because I didn't know what the f*** going on.
Yeah. That's true. That's true. They don't put captions for the pop-ups, do they?
What pop-ups? What are you talking about?
Like the Korean pop-ups that pop up on the screen?
No, they do.
Oh, they do.
There's a weird subtitle program that they have where, like, instead of just, like, the 1-2-line situation for, like, American shows, if there's, like, a pop-up, they'll have, like, the subtitle right next to the pop-up, bro. You know what I mean?
I've been making an effort to watch TV shows and movies without subtitles.
Bro. Korean?
No, not even just Korean, but just movies in general. You know how people tend to watch everything with subtitles now?
Yeah.
Because they want to read along?
Yeah.
But to me, it's like, I don't think that's how the filmmaker intended
the hell movie no. To You're sacrificing viewed. 37% of your vision to the freaking text.
I don't know about that big of a percentage.
Bro, it's just a third. Rule of thirds, think about it. Boom, boom, boom. You know, you're
it's
on the bottom of
it. Not that much, though.
Hey.
I will. Yeah. I kind of need it. I don't know why.
No, but I'm talking about English.
Yeah, English.
Oh, even English, English too.
Stuff? Yeah, I feel like people, and I saw like some video on this, like a lot of actors are more marbled mouthed than before.
I did see a Vox video about this, and they were talking about a lot of Christopher Nolan films. The audio is kind of hard to hear.
Yeah, for sure.
But I don't know. I'm trying to get back to just enjoying the visuals.
Yeah. No, I've thought about that too, though, for sure. I tried it, and then I'm like, I gotta go back.
Especially.
I need those subtitles.
Like comedy stand-up specials. Because the punchline's right there.
Oh, yeah.
They don't separate the joke from the build-up.
That's a good point.
So it's like, it's terrible. So we
But you
make
can still
sure.
enjoy. It's still
No. If I hear the punchline before, it's not. It's just, again.
Knife!
No,
but you're right, though. It does ruin the punchline.
Yeah.
I guarantee you, most people are probably watching stand-up specials with subtitles,
Absolutely.
Too.
Absolutely.
It's probably ruining their experience.
Yeah.
What are we going to do about this? Nothing.
Protest in the middle of the highway.
That's what we should be protesting. All right.
I love it.
Just a quick thought. Another thing that grinds my gears.
Mm.
They got to update the USB ports on the little screens on your flights to USB-C.
Still such like a third world.
You want everyone
problem.
To catch up.
No, I'm just saying they got the old classic USB ports.
Right.
Everyone's using the USB-C. I can't charge my shit on the flight.
That is true.
You'll live.
That's true. Why don't you bring the block? Why don't you bring the block?
Because sometimes they don't have the port for your your plug, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Just have one on deck, bro. Like,
it was just a short rant.
Yeah,
just hoping
it.
That United or Delta it. Is watching, you know, which they're not. But that's my last rant. Is there any other rants from you? Rek doesn't really have any rants. He seems like he's like fine
calm
with everything.
Down. Like, I don't know.
He's very calm. Dude. This is not the usual Rek I'm used to.
I'm having a good, I feel like I have a good life.
Man, I'm happy for you, man. This is the same guy I remember like opening up trash bags in New York City and scattering them across the middle of the street.
But truth be told, I was happy then too.
That's true.
I feel like I'm just a pretty content guy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You have been pretty chill. And right. You haven't been hitting any of us up. Has that increased your happiness? Not interacting with us?
No. I see you guys though. I see y'all like once a week at least.
Even when you're with us, yeah, you're not with us, bro. Yeah.
But I mean, especially right now, I'm just working, head down, trying to make money,
right?
And
how's that going, man? Making that
it's
money,
good. Making some money.
That's good, bro.
It feels good, you know, not worrying about rent.
Whoa. Everyone worries about rent, man.
That's what you're talking about? Where are we eating worried. Tonight?
You not know? Worried, baby.
I pay rent sometimes, and I'm like, why am I doing this?
I'm thinking that now. I'm thinking that now.
I do feel like I can find ways to not pay rent.
Right.
Are you guys gonna, you think you'll live in LA forever?
Yeah. I love LA. Me I truly too, do. I don't.
I'm happy that I grew up in New York. New York has made me who I am.
Yeah.
And, but I feel like it also made me appreciate LA more. And I could really just see myself living and dying here.
All right, Tupac.
No, I honestly don't think I'll be happier living anywhere else. Yeah. Because I still need the city, the grit.
Yeah.
You know, and the space.
Mm-hmm.
And the food.
The homelessness has gotten a little out of control, huh?
I mean, it's there, but I feel like I'll get a different version of that in any other place. Like, like you're going to be in, like, the Midwest, and you're going to get some dude who, like, comes off homeless, you know? Like, he won't be homeless, but you're going to get, like, a dusty dude, you know what I mean?
You'll get the vibes.
What do you mean?
You're going to get, like, a dusty neighborhood old
guy. So you're saying he's not even a homeless guy?
He's not homeless, but
he's judging the appearance.
He's going to be, like, a dusty neighborhood old guy who frequents the pub, you know, like frequents the bar that, you know.
No,
so there's always going to be a version of like your local neighbor who's like,
right.
Might not be as kept as you prefer.
There's poverty everywhere. You know what I mean?
There is. I'm not even talking about poverty. You could have money and you could still
about
be
unkempt people, bro.
You could still be that vibe.
I mean, you've been to Korea. You don't see that at all.
There's still people in Korea that annoy
me. Wait, there's no homeless people in Korea at all? Nah.
Like, there's house people that annoy me more than homeless people. I'm being real. There's so many, like, annoying little, like...
secure people?
There's people, even in Korea, right, where it is super clean.
Yeah.
But how many times have you gone into a subway and seen the faces of somebody that just rubs you the wrong way? Come on, or they're just like, I don't know. You know, the vibes are off.
Not really.
Really? I think there's vibes off everywhere.
Could you live in Korea?
Well, yeah, there's vibes off everywhere, but not enough for me to be like... Because think about what I'm talking about. Like, okay, one thing is I grew up taking the public transportation.
Mm.
I know about why there's a train car empty.
Yeah.
Because, you know...
There's feces in there.
It just stinks.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And then I've taken public transportation here.
Mm.
Wild.
I've never taken a metro yet.
LA,
you
LA,
walk on the bus, and then there's literally somebody's foot like this, and they're just rubbing Vaseline on it. And this is 9 in the morning.
That is crazy.
And then somebody's playing a soundtrack.
Yeah.
Blasting beats, and you're just trying to go to work.
I'm not gonna lie,
rubbing Vaseline on your feet is crazy.
Yeah, you literally walk on, and it's like a Universal Studios ride. You're like, oh, this is the first exhibit. And then this is happening.
But I will say this, you're right.
Someone stabbed somebody in Echo Park in the neck.
But are you saying it's crazier here in public transportation in LA than New York City?
I think it might be.
You know why? Because in New York, everybody takes a train.
Right.
Like rich people, you know, you know, middle class, everybody.
Yeah.
Here, it's like almost like it's just mostly like homeless people.
The craziest thing is, like, just recently, I used to take the bus and subway all the time as a kid, just growing up in L.A.
Hip-hop.
And recently, I was like, oh, I missed that. I'm going to just take the subway today. Yeah. I went on the subway. It was so crazy down there.
What are you talking about?
It was so crazy.
Compare that to what you're doing in Korea. Somebody rubbed you the wrong way because of how they look?
I came up the stairs and I was like shaking. I'm never going down there again.
Uber XL, I go.
That's crazy.
I mean, it's just...
And yeah, not just, you know, like homeless people are people too, but...
Yeah.
There is a mental issue. Like,
yeah, for sure.
I just think the Korea, there's a lot of stress that oozes off. Like, I'm not really stressed in like an LA, New York City subway ride. You know, it's like, it's cool.
LA, I don't really feel the stress. New York, there is a cloud of stress, bro. When you're in the metropolis, hell yeah, dude.
It's not as bad as like downtown LA.
Oh, I'm talking about just like the hustle and bustle of it. Downtown LA is a whole different...
You go downtown LA, you just, I mean, maybe... Maybe you gotta kind of like tap into it. Like, if you're more like aware of like just vibe and shit, like, not sound like a mystic or some, but like, you just feel the negativity, bro. Like the hopelessness, the despair, and it's kind of sad, dude. Like, when I go down there, I just don't feel good, man. And it doesn't help that when I stand on like a block, you just stand like maybe outside of like Peter's studio.
Yeah.
Somebody's hitting you up every 5 seconds.
Yeah.
Literally. Every 10 seconds, somebody's got something to say to you about some shit that, you know.
Well, you're saying you feel the hopelessness and despair in the LA streets, like downtown. In New York, does it feel like more hopeful? Like, my dreams, this is the Big Apple. But it's like, not, anything it, can
it's not as bad.
Be accomplished.
It's not as bad. Maybe it's getting countered by positive energy.
That's there's true. There's just so much energy.
Yeah, there's a balance there, but in downtown, it's like
there's a glum moroseness to it, for sure.
Even like K-Town's feeling kind of bad nowadays, you know.
I mean, you can say that about your algorithm, though. I mean, I'm saying most people are on their phones. You can run into tons of negative energy or positive energy on there.
Damn, what a flip right there, buddy.
That's more of the traffic, the highway of information. When's the last time you heard somebody call the internet the highway of information?
I'm about to punch you in the face right now.
So over here. I'm about to punch but I'm saying, though, that's like, I guess your algorithm is a reflection of you and like all the content that you subscribe to.
Yeah.
But you taking a walk, like me just walking over here, somebody like cursed me out. Yeah. Like some random dude.
Today? Did it happen?
Yeah.
Really?
That's not my algorithm.
What did they say?
That's not my algorithm.
I don't even know what they're saying. They're just, maybe it wasn't cursing at me directly, but they were just like, fuck off.
He received that.
That wasn't to you, bro.
And I was just like, no, he was looking at me. And I was just like,
that's a good question. For me personally, like the way that I view LA or any spot that has kind of like issues, before I could tolerate it. But now, because I have a son, I have no tolerance for it. You know what I mean? Like me looking on Citizen app and I see women getting beat by a barbecue grill. Like before Caden, I'm like, oh, that's funny. Now it's like, I don't want Caden to be in the vicinity of this. You know what I mean?
Wait, why was that funny? This woman getting beat by a barbecue grill.
That's a barbecue. Not funny, but you know, it's just like, this is unorthodox.
It'd be funny because it's usually a woman beating a guy with a barbecue
grill. Yeah. Maybe that was it. But it's just, you know, like my last trip to Virginia, the like secure bubble, the thing that I despised the most, the thing that I was the most like angry about, like, why'd you keep me safe here? You know, kind of like it, you know.
Now
kinda,
you want to return,
I kind of want that for my son now, you know.
Yeah,
and I'd
you understand
rather
that now.
I do understand that now, yeah, you know, the aquarium life that my mom
that's
put
the craziest
me in.
With you know, having a kid, I feel like. I see is that you kind of see things through the perspective of your kid now.
Bro, to the littlest things. Do you remember those memories that we have of like your dad shampooing your hair and it's like mad rough? It's like, you know, just lathering it up. I'm doing it mad gently to my son, but he's so little that his face is bouncing off. And I'm like, I'm remembering it. I'm like, damn, that's what it must feel like. You know what I mean? Like the perspective change. It's cool. It's like having a kid, like you get to live your youth one more time.
I honestly don't think my parents handled me with care.
No, bro.
You know, they were a little bit rough around the edges. Like,
right.
Yeah, you're right. Like, I like
what's, what's the most f***ing thing that your parents did?
I just always remember getting dragged. Like when we're walking down the street, I feel my arm just getting pulled. I don't remember a piggyback ride or a ride on the shoulders. Like when I think of like times with my parents, like heading somewhere, I just feel like my arm is being dragged. Like, you know?
But you know what though? I feel like that could have been you problem.
Yeah,
what do you mean? I feel like you got distracted, and they're like, "Get the fuck over here, bro."
Exactly.
No, maybe I'm choosing to block out the good moments. You know, maybe they existed. Who knows?
Do you guys have specific memories of like things that you liked, like really early on when you were young and you're becoming a human being and starting to form an opinion and you know perspective on things? Like, when I was young, I loved like Godzilla films.
Oh,
like okay. Whenever we passed the video store, I would be like, but the weird thing is, I would always have like a weird obsession with something, and then I might like move on after a little while. But I'll still enjoy that thing like when it comes out. So I think my life, like you know how I love like K-pop, right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's like a weird
he's
obsession.
He's obsessed with it. He's flown out.
I'm not obsessed.
You flew, bro, you you're flew obsessed. To New York. I'm not obsessed. You flew obsessed. Out to New York City for a K-pop concert, mm-hmm. an IVE concert.
That's obsession, that's bro. Crazy.
It's not yeah, I mean, it's more like, I can do it, so why not?
I saw your YouTube.
It wasn't like, I respect it. I gotta go! No,
but I respect the fandom. I like anybody yeah. who's a hardcore fan of something, because I think I've had even moments in my past where I've been embarrassed to fan out about something. So the
what, you like, flew out to the East Coast to catch
a
show?
No, but I'm saying to have the security to be like, I'm a fan of this or that. Yeah. Like, that's, now I'm there. Like, now I can say that. Right, so I do right, respect right. that. You
that
know what
true.
I mean?
Yeah. That is true.
Honestly, I think that when it's something that I'm not supposed to like, I like to push it more and be more public about it.
Yeah.
Because I, you know.
Let me ask you, what spoke to you about Godzilla? Why Godzilla?
I think it was Godzilla and I think dinosaurs in general. I was like, you know, like when you're like a boy, like you either like guns and like cars and like, you know, like machines and yeah. or you like animals and like.
That's true.
So you lean like, towards the animal side.
Yeah. Like yeah.
And you like the giant animals.
I just, yeah, that. And then like I had a weird obsession with like Wizard of Oz, like books, like, you know, like,
you told me about this.
There's Wizard of Oz. And then, you know, there's like 12 books, like oh, in a whole, there's a whole series.
Yeah. Yeah.
And like,
do you think you were obsessed or because it was accessible? Because it was like a collection.
It was inaccessible.
Oh, you didn't have it.
So
you
that's what. No, no, no.
Wait, hold on. You seeking out Wizard of Oz books is crazy.
Yeah, no, I would go. I would look up like public libraries and like yeah. call and be like, "Yo, do you have this book?"
You really wanted to finish the journey.
Yeah, and then like Godzilla too. Like there was a lot of video stores with just like the most popular one. So I had to look for like the other joints.
Right, right.
So like I think that.
A DITC mentality.
Yeah, that you know, I think like we do that too. Yeah. You know, yeah. we like dig and, you know.
To nauseam.
It's been like that with, you know, with porn.
Right.
With hip hop. Yeah.
I was just obsessed with things that I would just watch on TV. I would just be obsessed with stuff I just, that would come up on my TV. So it's like, I Love Lucy, Alf, Small Wonder.
Right.
You know.
Yeah, that I was never obsessed with. Because like, yeah. these are all these shows that would come on. And honestly, I was like, I don't want to see, I don't want to watch this. There was ones that I did like, but those, especially the ones that you just named, felt like so old fashioned.
I know, but it was just like bugged out. These were bugged out shows.
I can appreciate them now, for sure.
Yeah.
But I was like, I don't want to watch this.
Yeah.
I'd rather watch Ninja Turtles back then.
I mean, I watched cartoons too.
Bro, you know what cartoon I loved? I don't know if you guys messed with this. You guys watch Ren and Stimpy?
Yeah,
Ren and Stimpy. You can't have a show like that anymore.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
So you guys have
and Beavis and Butthead.
Beavis and Butthead.
Yeah,
but I didn't have MTV.
Animation style. I love too.
Like guys, yeah, seeing cartoons that were kind of adult was crazy.
Hell
like,
yeah.
Oh, my bad. Keep
no, it's all good. I just, you know, you're talking about what was like something I loved. I wasn't thinking about pop culture or movies or anything like that when I was a kid. I'm gonna be honest with you. I was crazy about smells, bro. Like my first memory. Let me cook.
What do you mean?
My first experience of like a smell that I love, something I would go back to and just like stand there and breathe in, is like a freezer smell. You ever back in the day, open up your freezer, stick your head in there, and just inhale like crazy.
I never liked the smell of anything in my freezer. Cause it has that like ice, you know when there's like old ice smell.
Oh, bro, you gotta have smell. Like a few you gotta have some calamari in there. You gotta have some Korean stuff.
So you remember? Oh, you
there.
Like the Korean smells?
I don't know if it was Korean. It was like the Freon. I don't know what it was. It was just something like that. I love the smell of. Do you remember the salad, like the parrot, the flavored markers?
Yeah.
So if you smell something, do you like kind of retain that memory of the smell?
Absolutely.
Do you know what our farts smell like?
I know what your fart smells like. I don't know his fart smell.
What does my fart smell like?
It's kind of like tart. You have a tart fart.
You got a tart fart?
You have a tart fart. I know your fart smell very well.
I just hope you guys tell me if I have bad breath. Like
yeah, please. Me too.
That's the thing about LA is like, you get the drunk, coked out people with their breath in your face talking about their screenplays. Oh my gosh.
You narrowed down the person to one person.
Yeah.
No. It's not one person.
But with each example. No,
the fact that you guys put a face to that is hilarious, but I'm not talking about one person.
No, I got you.
But I am talking about the type of person LA.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Super excited.
Yeah.
I have an idea for sure.
People need to take key bumps of like crushed up mint.
Yeah. That's what they You want to bump an Altoid? Exactly.
Yeah. All right, should we wrap it up?
Let's wrap it up. That was great.
We got a good one. Is there anything else you guys want to talk about? Plug?
No, I'm working on a bop. I told you, a bop sauce, right? Like a flavor enhancer, like a rice
good
enhancer.
Name too.
Yeah,
bop sauce. Yeah, it's going to be crazy. Yeah. So off air, I kind of want to discuss some like flavor ideas with you guys.
So Rick, explain the sauce. This is sauce you mixing with your rice.
Yeah, so this company that creates sauces, they hit me up and they wanted like a face for this line and they gave me freedom to kind of create my own sauce. I'll be doing the R&D, like tasting it, making sure like it's up to par. And
I'd love to help with marketing, bro.
Yeah, hell yeah. You know, when you think of like Korean sauces, it usually boils down to like the gochujang sauce, you know, like that red, like sweet, spicy. But I want to do something where instead of like making it a dip sauce, you kind of spray it, you kind of like take a dollop over your rice and PBR it. You know, Justin PBR, right?
Yep.
So kind of like a soy sesame seed, soy sauce. You know, like the stuff that you can make.
That'd be perfect with? Because I put like, you know, a couple things. But bomb. If I just had one.
Yeah, exactly. That's cut some scallion
put
up.
Some egg on
so
it.
Yeah, you know, it's in the good early idea. Stages. But yeah, man. So
and you can dip it. Yeah, and put it on sandwiches.
Dip it.
You could have mad different flavors. Like this is a line, bro.
Dude, it's gonna be that good, young. You know what I mean? It's gonna be good.
Rek, what can we expect from you, man? When are we gonna hear this new music you've been working on? I didn't mean to say it like that. Sorry.
I didn't think.
Yeah.
I guess you know. Next month, probably.
Sick.
Yeah.
Any features?
When you leave, dang.
It's a lot of within the family, the 8-Ball Town.
I might want to do a verse, man. It's been a while since I wrote a verse.
Yeah. We can still add.
Oh, okay.
Let's do something.
Yeah.
You want to all...
We should all do a Congress song.
Yeah, let's do a Congress song.
Let's do a Congress song. That'd
be sick. I have a beat.
I love me some good Conglish.
Okay.
My God. Dude, I know I keep saying this, but let's do this more often. I need this right now. Like, just talking, shooting the amazing.
That's good, man. No babies around.
Come on.
It's kind of good, huh?
Yeah.
No baby crying. Like, you don't have so to... Good.
Katie's listening.
No. I'm just going
to... He's watching.
Just gonna drive around.
Kaden
for a little
is a
bit.
Really chill baby, man.
He's a good kid.
He's a good kid.
He's a great
kid.
Very, very good kid. His cheeks are so cute, pudgy. That's what made me want a kid. I was like, you know what? I could have one of
these. Whoa.
Yeah. Could have one of these kids.
Kaden does have that, you know what they say. A kid is kind of contagious. You have one, you hold one, you smell one, you kiss one. Kind of want one. You know what I mean?
I kind of want a baby.
Yeah.
I do. I think I'd be a good dad.
Work on the partner first, bro. You know what I mean?
That's true. I should think
about that.
You're
over here
thinking
about the yangnyeom when you didn't even think about the ingredients yet.
You know what I mean? But if I find that right one,
what?
I'm not pulling out.
If I have a baby, I'm still gonna go with the pod idea.
What?
The pod.
Oh.
Incubator.
Oh yeah. I
think why are you
incubator?
No, you're gonna want to hold it, but you know.
Yeah, I'll have visitation.
Mm. You know,
we'll call them sessions.
If you have a baby, there's gonna be sacrifices. No more video games, you know.
No, I'm gonna parent them through the video game,
like a Tamagotchi.
Yeah.
All right,
that's great.
All right, guys. Rick Lee, Rek Stizzy. Thanks for tuning in to another episode of Fun with Dumb, y'all. Peace.